गुड इवनिंग माय डियर चिल्ड्रन, टुडे विल स्टार्ट अ लिटिल मैच गर्ल, हैंस क्रिश्चियन एंडरसन। सो विल स्टार्ट अ स्टोरी व्हिच इज पैथेटिक इन नेचर दैट अराइजेस अ काइंड ऑफ पिटी इनसाइड आवर हार्ट। वी फील वेरी मच सिंपैथेटिक फॉर दैट पुअर लिटिल गर्ल। ऑलरेडी इंट्रोडक्शन इज डन इन द लास्ट वीडियो। So in this video, we'll go through the text. First, let us see the setting. This is not an ordinary day. This is 31st night, New Year Eve. Basically, this day is for making parties, having fun, total festivity. But the atmosphere is gloomy. Not only that atmosphere of weather is gloomy, not like that only. The surrounding, the situation, the condition, everything looks very gloomy. It was bitterly cold. Snow was falling and darkness was gathering, for it was the last evening of the old year. It was New Year's Eve. First, keep it in mind when we are given any text that tells us the situation. Situation means the the climatic condition, the scenario, and all other things. That is called setting. So this is the setting of our very story. What does the settings tell? That the night was shivering cold, snow was falling, and darkness was gathering. And it was the last day of the old year, that means 31st night. In the cold and gloom, a poor little girl walked bareheaded and barefoot. So this is her physical condition. She did not have warm clothes to cover herself. Neither did she have any kind of shoe or slipper so that she can wear. She had been wearing slippers, it is true, she had been wearing, not presently. Previously, she was wearing a blazer, slipper. It is true, when she left home, but what good were they? That means they were of no good, of no value, of no importance. She had been wearing slippers, it is true, when she left home, but what good were they? Actually, those slippers did not belong to her own. Those slippers were larger in size because the slipper belonged to her mother. So what happened? These slippers are just called slippers. Literally, there is no use of those slippers. They had been her mother's. So you can imagine how big they were. The little girl had lost them as she ran across the street to escape from two carriages. Means a cart or car. Car will not take, will consider this as cart. Because if you look at the situation, it is not the present day situation. This is long time back this is written. So what we can consider here? The carts, horse driven cart. Two carriages that were being driven terribly fast. One sleeper could not be found and a boy had run up with the other. So first of all, those sleepers were not her own, and second thing, she lost both the sleepers since she was crossing the road, and all of a sudden two carriages came or two carts came and she had to rush to to cross the road and go to another side, and while doing so she lost one of the sleepers, and another was taken by a notorious boy who belonged to the same social category like that very girls. He is also a poor boy. Otherwise, no one will steal a single piece of sleeper from anyone. That person could have taken both. So one is taken, that means that boy cannot be a rich fellow. That means he does belong to the same category, just like that poor little girl. And why did he take that one? He had particular motto for that one. That was the aim of his life. People have different aims in their life, that will do this and that. But look, that poverty has spoiled their childhood, spoiled their life. And what is their aim here? Just see. And a boy had run up with the other, saying that it would come in very handy as a cradle some day when he had children of his own. That means when he will have children, that time those sleepers will help him. That sleeper will help him because he will make a cradle, means jhula, out of that one, in order to nourish or take care of the little boy when he will be father. So that is the aim of his life, that someday he will be a father, and that day his children, his child is going to be taken care of in that particular sleeper. So that will be a cradle or jhula for her, his child. So the dream is very small here. We have to accept that when there is no food to fill up your stomach, you cannot dream big. Yes, dream can be big if you have proper surrounding, proper economical and social situation, but here there is no socio-economical standard. They are empty stomach. You cannot expect them to behave like a normal person. Next. So the little girl walked about the street on her naked feet, which were red and blue with the cold. It was too cold that those little feet, little size feet, became cold, very cold, and it was blue and black in color. That means it was terribly cold, and she was walking. Just think about it. We are walking in such cold weather. We cover our legs with socks, then shoes. We cover our head, we cover our body with sweater and woolen clothes. And look, that girl is walking without proper protection. In her old apron, it is not a kind of frock, it is a kind of apron. Very pathetic condition, that is why it is written apron. She carried a great many matches. Inside the pockets of the cloth, what was there? Many matches, great many matches, some number, not mentioned clearly, that is good in number. Matchboxes were there. So goes the title, the little match girl. Nobody had brought any from her, but no one had purchased a single one. They had money to spend in luxury. People had money to install lights. People have money to decorate their house. People have money to waste that. But they have no money to distribute, to help poor. And no one had given her a single penny all day. She has not contributed with a single penny. So this is the naked side of the society. There is no sympathy. There is no fellow feeling. She crept along. She did not walk. She crept along, means walk very slowly. Very slowly. Shivering and hungry. The picture of misery. She was the picture of misery, means pathetic condition. If somebody tells you that the condition of that girl is very pathetic, you should think about the picture of this little girl. She herself is a symbol, a model of misery. The poor little thing. She is really poor. A little one. Very little. The snowflakes fell on her long golden hair, that means head was not covered, which curled so prettily about her neck. She had short hair till her neck, and those are curled without any proper care. She looked really beautiful. You can imagine the picture of that little one. She is really beautiful. It's really cute. And her golden hair were curled up, and what happened? That snowflakes were falling on her hair, as if like God is showering flowers on her. But what is the need of that flower? Instead, God should shower some food upon her. But keep it in mind, God will never allow anyone to live in long misery. God will somehow provide some measures. And in this case, for this girl, God will take her out of this painful, pathetic world, to that world where there is no hunger, no pain, no pathetic condition, no hatred. There is only love. Let's see what happens next. But she did not think of her appearance now. She is not at all bothered of her appearance. How does she look? That valueless matter to her. Lights were shining in every window, and there was a glorious smell of roast goose in the street. For this was New Year's evening and she could not think of anything else. She had to sell the matchsticks. You know, if you are hungry and if you get the smell of something good, you will feel very pathetic in that case. So that girl already hungry, and what happens here? And she is just getting the smell of something delicious. She cannot do anything. She can't return home. Father will beat. She huddled down in a heap, in a corner, formed by two houses. Two houses were there, forming a particular corner, just like bee. Think one bee is falling on the ground. So both the hands of the bee are the two houses. If I make my fingers like this, this is one house, this is another house. Okay. So see, in between those that place, she sat. Huddled down, putting the head on her knees, and she sat down there, just like the boy in that face in darks was sitting, one of which projected further out into the street. One house is, just think, one of the hands of the V is longer than another one. Okay. So, one of those houses projected out into the street than the other. One is larger than other. One can be seen in greater way than other. But though she tucked her little legs up under her, she felt colder and colder. She tried to save herself from that shivering cold, but she could not. She was trying to put her head in between two knees, but she could not save herself from that rude and crude shape of nature. She did not dare to go home. She can't go home also, for she had sold no matches and earned not a single penny. So it was hard for her to return home also. Now think about the parents also. This is their own child, but they cannot do anything. They are also poor. So you can see the world, the pathetic side of the world is here unveiled, is unfolded very clearly. Very pathetic condition, that we can say. Okay, so here we end today. If you have any doubt, do ask me that one via WhatsApp or in comment section. I will surely answer you back. Stay safe, stay protected. Thank you, dear children.